गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू सोशल साइंस रिवीजन ऑनलाइन टीचिंग क्लासेस फ्रॉम विश्व मानव रेसिडेंशियल हाई स्कूल। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस 1 मार्क्स, 2 मार्क्स एंड 3 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन आंसर्स इन द लेसन फ्रीडम मूवमेंट। Okay, let's start. The first main, choose the right option and fill in the blanks. The first question in this lesson, in the multiple choice, the founder of Indian National Congress is option A. Mahatma Gandhi, B. A.O. Hume, C. Bal Gangadhar Tilak, D. Gopala Krishna Gokhale. The right answer is A.O. Hume. A.O. Hume is the founder of Indian National Congress. Then, second question, Maratha paper was published by option Jawaharlal Nehru, option B, Ras Bihari Bose, option C, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, and option D, V.D. Savarkar. The right answer is Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Maratha paper was published by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Then, third question. Muslim League was founded in option A, 1924, option B, 1922, option C, 1929, and option D, 1906. The right answer is 1906. In that year, Muslim League was founded, isn't it? Then, fourth question. The Viceroy who implemented the Bengal Division was option A, Lord Carnavalis, option B, Dalhousie, option C, Lord Curzon, and option D, Robert Clive. The right answer is Lord Curzon. Lord Curzon became the Viceroy who implemented the Bengal Division, that is Lord Curzon. So this is about the multiple choice questions and answers in this lesson. Now let's move on the 1 marks question and answers. The first question, when did Indian National Congress established? See here, answer. The Indian National Congress was established in the year 1885. Then, second question, who founded the Indian National Congress? Answer, A.O. Hume founded Indian National Congress. Then, third question, who is the first president of Indian National Congress? Very simple, very easy. Answer, W.C. Banerjee. W.C. Banerjee became the first president of Indian National Congress. Isn't it? Then, fourth question. When did Muslim League founded? Answer, 1906. In that year, Muslim League was founded. Then, fifth question. Who introduced the Vernacular Press Act? Answer, Lord Lytton introduced the Vernacular Press Act. Then, sixth question, who present the drawing theory? Answer, Dadabhai Nauroji present the drawing theory. Dear students, Dadabhai Nauroji explained about the transfer of Indian wealth to England. It is called as drawing theory, isn't it? Dadabhai Nauroji present the drawing theory. Then, seventh question, who were known as political beggars by radicals? Answer, moderates. Then, eighth question, what do you mean by radicals? Answer, the group congressmen who criticize the soft stance of moderates, it is called as a radicals. Then, ninth question, who implemented the Bengal Division? Answer, Lord Curzon implemented the Bengal Division. So these are the 1 marks question and answers in this lesson. Now let's move on the 2 marks and 3 marks question and answers. The first question: which were the organizations in India before the establishment of the Indian National Congress? See here, which were the organizations in India before the establishment of the Indian National Congress? Answer: the Hindu Mela, All Indian Association, Purna Public Sabha, and the Indian Association. Isn't it? Were the organizations in India before the establishment of Indian National Congress? Then, second question: list out moderate leaders. Who are the moderate leaders? One is M.G. Narade. Second one is Sudhendranath Banerjee, Dadabhai Nauroji, and Gopala Krishna Gokhale were the prominent leaders of moderates. Isn't it? Then, third question: what were the demands put forward by moderates to the British? Very important. What were the demands of moderates placed in front of the British? Or what were the demands put forward by moderates to the British? Very simple answer. See here, the first point: the moderates trust the British administration and their impiety. They used to place their request and appeals before the government within the constitutional framework. Then third point: the moderates thought people about political situations. Then fourth point: they conduct meetings, discussed problems and place before the government. And the last point: the various requests related to government, the development of industries, reduction of military expenses, improvement in education are submitted. See here, in the demands of moderates placed in front of the British, we can see cut down of military expenditure, isn't it? Development of Indian industries, providing good education, programs for poverty alleviation. So these are the demands of moderates placed in front of the British, isn't it? Then fourth question: describe the theory of wealth drain. Describe the theory of a wealth drain, or explain drain theory. See, the theory which explains the transfer of Indian wealth to England is known as theory of wealth drain. See here, very important. For the first time, the moderates critically analyzed the ill effects of British rule in India. They placed before the people facts and figure about the drain of Indian wealth into England. See here, in the drain theory, Dadabhai Nauroji explained about the transfer of Indian wealth to England, and it is called as a drain theory. Isn't it? So this is about the drain theory or wealth drain. Then fifth question: list out the revolutionaries' organizations. List out the revolutionaries' organizations. See here, answer: the revolutionaries' organizations, we can see Abhinava Bharata, Anushila Samiti, Gadha, Lotus, and Dragger. These are the important revolutionaries' organization. Once again, I repeat, the important revolutionaries' organizations: Abhinava Bharata, Anushila Samiti, Gadha, and Lotus and Draggers. Then, sixth question: name the revolutionaries in the freedom movement. Or, Name the important revolutionary leaders of Indian freedom struggle. See here, Arvind Ghosh, V.D. Sarvakar, Ashwini Kumar Datta, isn't it? Rajguru, Vishnu Shastri, Ras Bihari Bose, Madam Kama, Khudiram Bose, Ram Prasad Bismil, isn't it? Bhagat Singh, Chandrasekhar Azad. So these are the revolutionaries, leaders in the freedom movement. Then, seventh question, very important in your examination point of view. So all of you listen carefully. Very important. The seventh question, explain the role of Bal Gangadhar Tilak in the freedom struggle. Explain the role of Bal Gangadhar Tilak in the freedom struggle. Dear students, this question is very important in your examination point of view. So all of you listen carefully. See here, Bal Gangadhar Tilak is a famous radicals leader. All of you know that Bal Gangadhar Tilak is a famous radicals leader. Bal Gangadhar Tilak declared, "Swaraj is my birthright and I will get it at any cost. Swaraj is my birthright and I will get it any cost," said by Bal Gangadhar Tilak, isn't it? Then he started preparing the common people for freedom struggle through Ganesha Chaturthi and Shivaji Jayanti. Bal Gangadhar Tilak utilized his Kesari and Maratha newspaper for spreading awareness among people. He started home rule movement. He also led the Swadeshi movement. He also joined hand with Lala Lajpat Rai and Bipin Chandra Pal, call it as Lal Bal Pal, sacrificed his life for Indian freedom. See here, the role of Bal Gangadhar Tilak in the freedom struggle. See, Bal Gangadhar Tilak was one of the important leaders among the radicals. All of you know that. He declared, "Swaraj is my birthright and I will get it at any cost." Thus, an independent India was the main aim of him. He started preparing the common people for freedom struggle. Through religious functions, they started organizing people for freedom movement. Bal Gangadhar Tilak utilized his Kesari in Maratha, Marathi and Maratha newspaper in English for spreading awareness among people about freedom struggle. So, through these papers, he called for the active participation of people in the fight of freedom movement. So, this is about the role of Bal Gangadhar Tilak in the freedom struggle. Then, let's move on. Another very important question in this chapter. What were the reasons for the withdrawal of Bengal division? Are a lot of residents of Indians led to the withdrawal of Bengal divisions? Explain. Very important. See here, the division of Bengal in 1905 was opposed by Indian Congress. Second point, still the Bengali language could unite the Hindus and Muslims community. The division of Bengal resulted in the widespread protest across the country. The radicals took the issues to the doorsteps of common people. So they called for boycotting of foreign goods and the institutions that encourage it. Indians were encouraged to use local goods. Then the British government withdrew the Bengal division order in the year 1911. So this is about the reason for withdrawal of Bengal division. So these are the very important question and answers in the lesson Freedom Movement. And now let's move on. The another important chapter in the history part 2, the 8th lesson, that is era of Gandhi and national movement. Dear students, this chapter is very very important in your examination point of view. This chapter is asked for 4 marks. So all of you listen carefully. The first question, what were the internal tools of Gandhi's struggle? All of you know that the internal tools of Gandhi's struggle, one is Satyagraha, second one is Ahimsa, third one is unity of Hindus and Muslims, fourth one is non-violence, fifth one is truth, and the last one is fasting. So these are the internal tools of Gandhi's struggle. Then second question, describe the role of Gandhi in Indian freedom struggle. Very important. See here, the role of Gandhi in the Indian freedom struggle, we can see he participate in Champaran and Khedha movement. He fight for the rights of Ahmedabad mill workers. He opposed the Rowlatt Act. He joined hand with Khilafat movement. He condemned the Jallianwala Bagh. He organized the non-corporation movement. He also organized the civil disobedience movement. He led the Quit India movement, and he stressed the development of untouchables. So these are the role of Gandhi in freedom struggle. Very important, the role of Gandhi in freedom struggle. Mahatma Gandhi participated in Champaran and Khedha movement and also fight for rights of Ahmedabad mill workers, Rowlatt Act, Khilafat movement, Jallianwala Bagh, non-corporation movement, and he also organized civil disobedience movement, Quit India movement, isn't it? So this is about the role of Gandhi in freedom struggle. Then third question, very important, list out the programs of non-corporation movement. What are the programs of non-corporation movement? See here, boycotting schools, colleges and courts. Second point, boycotting elections to regional legislative bodies held according of 1919 Act. Third one is returning all honors, awards and medals given by British. Fourth one is nominated members to the local body resisting from their membership. Fifth one is boycotting all the government functions, and the last one is boycotting all foreign goods. So these are the programs of non-corporation movement. Very very important. See, the Congress passed a revolution to hold non-corporation movement in its special national convention held in Calcutta on the September 4th, 1920. Supporting this movement, Motilal Nehru, C.R. Das, boycotting schools, colleges and courts, boycotting elections to regional legislative bodies held according of 1919 Act, and retaining all the honors and medals given by the British, nominated members to the local bodies resigning from their membership, boycotting all the government functions, boycotting all foreign goods. So these are the programs of non-corporation movement. Then fourth question, explain the Chauri Chaura incident. See here, in the year 1922, on February 5, 1920, a big group of around 3,000 farmers assembled in front of the police station. See, they had assembled there to protest against the police officer who had beaten Congress workers when they were protesting in front of an attack shop. See here, in the year 1922, thousands of people jumped into the freedom struggle at Chauri Chaura in Uttar Pradesh. Police used their force against peaceful protesters. See here, in the Chauri Chaura incidents, the police started shooting from inside the station. Enraged by this act, people torched the police station. As a result, all the 22 policemen were charged to death. Such violent incidents were repeated in other places. Gandhiji realized that this due to lack of preparation and morality among the people to hold non-violence protest. Hence, he withdrew the non-corporation movement on February 12, 1922. So, this is about the history of Chauri Chaura incident. Then, fifth question, describe the salt satyagraha. Very important. See here, the salt satyagraha is also known as Dandi March, isn't it? This movement was started by Gandhiji in the year 1930, when Viceroy Lord Irwin refused to fulfill the Gandhiji's 11 demands. Gandhiji traveled from Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi on foot with his followers to produce salt in seashore of Dandi. By distributing salt to people, Gandhiji broke the British law on salt and started the civil disobedience movement. See, in the salt satyagraha, we can see it is known as Dandi March. This movement was started in the year 1930, in the time when Viceroy Lord Irwin, isn't it? The Gandhiji fulfilled 11 demands. Gandhi traveled from Sabarmati Ashrama to Dandi on foot with his followers to produce salt in seashore of Dandi. So this is about salt satyagraha. Then fifth question, what were the reasons for the failure of Quit India movement? Answer, on the 8th August 1942, Congress started the Quit India movement. Second point, Gandhiji gave a call to Indians, do or die. Gandhiji called to Indians, do or die. In this contest, Gandhiji, Nehru and all leaders were imprisoned. Then, there is a lack of leadership to movement. By utilizing transport and telecommunication, British suppressed the movement. Muslim League did not participate in this struggle. There is a lack of proper directions to movement. So, this is about the reason for failure of a Quit India movement. Then, seventh question. Explain the achievements of Subhash Chandra Bose in the independence struggles. Very, very important for your examination point of view. This question is asked for 4 marks. What are the achievements of Subhash Chandra Bose in the independence struggle? So, all of you listen carefully. The most prominent among the revolutionary fighters of India was Subhash Chandra Bose. Answer. The first point, all of you know that Subhash Chandra Bose was popularly called as Netaji. He participated in non-corporation movement along with Gandhiji. Subhash Chandra Bose, the Congress Socialist Party in the year 1934 along with Nehru. Fourth point, Subhash Chandra Bose became the president at Haripur session of Indian National Congress. Fifth point, Netaji left the Congress and established a separate party called Forward Bloc. Then Subhash Chandra Bose gained the support of German director Hitler to make India free. He became leader to Indian National Army. Subhash Chandra Bose gave call Delhi Chalo. Then he argued, the Indians give me blood, I will give you freedom. Subhas Chandra Bose had planned a military strategy through Rangoon to capture Delhi. Then finally, Subhas Chandra Bose died in plane accident. So, this is about the achievements of Subhas Chandra Bose in the independence struggle. Then, 8th question. Describe the various tribal revolt in the history of independence movement. What were the tribal revolts in the history of independence movement? See here, answer. The Tax and Forest Act implemented by British East India Company. The tribal revolt. Of the tribal rebellions, the Shantala revolt and Munda movement are prominent. In this regard, the Halagali hunters rebellion in Karnataka is noteworthy. So this is about the various tribal revolts in the history of independence struggle. Then very important, the 9th question, explain the major achievements of Nehru as the Prime Minister of India. What are the major achievements of Jawaharlal Nehru as the Prime Minister of India? Very important. The first point, the major achievements of Nehru as the Prime Minister of India. He is the first Prime Minister of independent India. All of you know that. He is the architect of industrialization and modern India. Jawaharlal Nehru successfully brought together all the princely states. Then he laid the foundation for Indian democracy. He fulfilled task of reorganizing all the states on the basis of language. And he also introduced the mixed economic system. He laid the foundation for 5-year plans. He is the architect of Indian national foreign policy. He advocated non-aligned movement or non-aligned policy. And he also introduced Panchashila principles. So these are the major achievements of Nehru as the Prime Minister of India. So the next 10th question. What are the contributions of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar? Very, very important. What were the contributions of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar? The first point, in the contributions of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar strongly believed that political independence was meaningless without social independence. Isn't it? Political independence was meaningless without social independence. Then he carried out a study of caste system and came up with a plan to eradicate it. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar started Mahat and Kalaram temple movements. Isn't it? And he also attended the 3 round table conference and give valuable suggestions in that time. Then Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was a Diwan in the court of Maharaja of Baroda. Then he established an organization, Bahishkruta Hitakarani Sabha. Bahishkruta Hitakarani Sabha established an organization, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Then he is the founder of parties like Satantra, Karmika Party and Republican Party of India. Then he published various newspapers like Prabuddha Bharata, Janata Mukanayaka and Bahishkruta Bharata. Very, very important. Then he also worked towards the progress of agricultural labors. Then Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was chosen as the chairman of drafting committee of Indian National Constitutions. So this is about the main important contributions of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar in this lesson. See, these are the very, very important question and answers in this lesson, the era of Gandhi and national movement. Okay, my dear students, in today's class, we have discussed 1 marks, 2 marks and 3 marks question answers. In this lesson, freedom movement and era of Gandhi and national movement. Okay, my dear students, thank you.